California as many businesses consider leaving the state. A growing number of companies are now saying, Arizona, here we come. And that state is welcoming them with open arms.
We're open for business. We mean it.
KCRA 3 has learned nearly two dozen California firms are now planning to say goodbye to some of the highest taxes in the nation. Welcome back. I'm Edie Lambert.
And I'm Kelly DeMarco. It is all part of a campaign that launched the day after Prop 30 passed. KCRA 3's Mike Lurie traveled to Phoenix for this exclusive report.
They're landing now in Phoenix. California chief executives on the move, eager to relocate their companies and bring thousands of new jobs to Arizona. The CEOs will meet these Arizona mayors and other leaders proclaiming, now arriving, California.
Come to Arizona. It's a better place to do business.
Arizona is more than just desert. It's an oasis for Californians fed up with the highest personal income tax rates and the highest sales tax rates in the country. And California is the worst state in the nation to do business for 8 years in a row, according to Chief Executive Magazine.
We do not have the regulatory and tax and expense and anti-business attitude that exists in California.
It's our culture.
Barry Broom is the president of the Greater Phoenix Economic Council, and it was his idea to target California executives and lure them to Arizona. But first, he needed a marketing tool, and Governor Jerry Brown gave him one.
Let's hold up our Prop 30 signs.
Last November 6th, Brown convinced California voters to raise taxes by more than $6 billion annually.
And within an hour, we put the program together and went into the market.
So Prop 30 fueled the campaign?
Absolutely, completely. We had over 57 companies right off the bat.
And currently, 19 CEOs have told Broom they are definitely leaving California.
When the California chief executives come here to Arizona, they'll get an aerial tour of Greater Phoenix, just like this one. The campaign goal is to give them an overview of the region that might become their new home.
These are private residences that are below us on the golf course.
So this would be a likely candidate for the CEO of one of the companies that we're talking to now. I mean,
those CEOs will see the high-end housing market in Greater Phoenix, in an area where it appears that every home has a pool. And back on the ground, they'll meet with Arizona's top education leaders, including Dr. Michael Crow, the president of Arizona State University. He'll tell the CEOs,
we are here to be of service to you.
And at the state capitol, Arizona's top elected officials have open arms and open doors for the California CEOs. Their message, they'll take better care of California companies.
We'll be a state that they can rely on to not overburden their businesses when they're here. We're open for business. We mean it, and we're ready to go forward, and we're going to do what we can to get you here.
And the campaign is working. Business relocation expert Joe Vranich says his phone has been ringing nonstop.
The big motivating factor right now is the passage of Prop 30 in the last election. I like to say that the reason companies leave California is they're suffering death by a thousand cuts.
It's a sensitive subject for Governor Brown.
California's business climate, any concerns about that?
In 1975, Dow Jones put out a report called the Fairness Report that said California had the absolute worst business climate. That was 1975. The personal income of California was $150 billion. Today, it's close to $2 trillion. So take it with a grain of salt.
Brown established the Office of Business and Economic Development, GoBiz, to make California more competitive.
So it seems pretty clear that Arizona means business. What does California stand for?
We've always meant business. You know, California has always been a leader in innovation, a leader in business creation.
But other states, like Arizona, are already banking on a big exodus from California.
California did generate more than a quarter of a million new jobs in the last 12 months, but the state is on the brink of losing at least 19 companies that are fed up with the business climate here. Those 19 firms employ thousands of people and offer good salaries ranging from $75,000 to $150,000 a year. They are actively looking at Arizona right now. Not all of them will end up there, of course, but every one of them, we are told, is committed to leaving California.
Interesting take just to see how both states are reacting to this. Do we know who these companies are and where they're from?
Well, the companies are being very close to the vest right now, as you can imagine, not wanting to tip their hand because they haven't made a final decision. They don't know and don't want to alarm their labor force, but we do know they include life science companies, aerospace defense contractors, engine technology companies, along with software and digital companies. And in part two, coming up on Wednesday, we'll show you some of those companies and why they are moving.
Meantime, the governor of Texas, Rick Perry's in our state right now doing the exact same thing that Arizona is doing. So I think these other states see California as vulnerable.
They do. California is being gunned at right now.
Mike, great story. Thank you.